Okay, so my name is Adon Wilson Odhiambo, and born and raised in Kibera slums, and proud to be a Kiberan. I'm a photographer, and I've been doing photography for quite, maybe I can say a long period of time. Because I started photography in 2008, and the journey has been quite, it has not been an interesting journey for me. Like, it has been hard cooperating with people, trying to find some jobs, and trying to involve yourself in any activity that comes. I started photography as a simple thing. Like, I didn't choose which camera I was using. Like, I started with a small Olympus camera. That's like one of the craziest camera I've ever had. And in the year 2010, I ended up knowing my way on photography, like what I should do and what I should be concerned about and what I should concentrate on. From the first camera that I said, before I was using Olympus, and then I came into Canon, but then I started with a small Canon. Yeah, I don't know how to describe it, but it was just a small Canon that wasn't taking any clear images. Actually, it was a gift from someone, a lady, who was interested in my pictures, and she just left it for me to use it and until I get a new camera. Then I was working in an organization that has supported me from like when I was a kid, you know. So that was another advantage of me, like accessing the cameras. Then my whole life I've been like on the Canon side of life, you know, Canon side. I've lived on the Canon side. So yeah, I've tried the other cameras. I know the tricks and the skills in the other cameras, if given, or if given a chance to use them. And if I don't know how to use it, then I'll take like maybe 45 minutes or 30 minutes just going through it. If it's hard, then I go to the tutorials on YouTube, then know how to use the camera. But then I never let a camera go for free, you know? Like I'll never let a camera defeat me, you know? Yeah, so my best camera has been Canon. I've tried the Nikon. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, Nikon is good, but yeah, for me, on the view side, like, it was kind of not really tricky, but I'm used to Canon, you know?
Which Canon are you using right now?
So now I'm using Canon, like 7D, and then I'm using 5D Mark III. I'm using 100D, and I have a 700D. And all of these are coming from the organization that I'm working on, yeah. Okay, we have different types of photographies. As I said before I got into photography, I used to do like any type of picture that come, any type of thing that I get around. But then, from the experience that I was having, I had like the wood that I'm coming from, like Kibera, you know. We have people, you know. We have life. We have struggles. Like, we have hustles. People are struggling all the way, like from morning to dawn, from morning to evening, you know, and kids going to school. Then I had this, like, that's when I became a blogger, you know. Just realized that, oh, I should be writing something about the life that I'm going through, the life that I've lived in, the life that people are living in, you know. And there is when photography came in, you know. But then I became more interested in human photography, human and society photography, you know. Because I realized that this was the only advantage that I had, like, to explore myself, you know, apart from the other things, because financially I was not able to afford all the other, like, traveling around, you know. If you are a wildlife documentary photographer, you need to travel all the time. And I realized that I could not manage that, you know. So what I did was, I found the easiest thing, like, to be done and just considered my home. Then I said that this is where I'll start with. And it ended up helping me. On that, I found like some of the professional photographers. Like now, last year I worked with a lady from Sweden called Isabel Ni. And I also worked with another, what's his name? In December, I'm going to US to work with another professional photographer, Larry Labonte, who's coming from Minnesota. And one of my best, like, one of the other thing that I'm considering now is like Steve McCurry, if anyone might know him, but he's quite famous. So he's the one, he's like my target now. He's the one I'm targeting because he's been my, like, growing up as a photographer, I've just, like, he's the one who has been motivating me through his pictures. Someone realized that you've been working with these great people, and then that's when you're being recognized in Kenya. Like, oh, I've had this man who's been working with maybe a famous photographer like Larry Labonte, like, you know, like Steve McCurry, but then he lives in Kenya. Then that's where the society of Kenya, like the people in Kenya will start recognizing, you know? Because some people say that photography is easy, you know? People say that photography is just taking a camera, balancing the light, ISO, shutter speed, aperture, then you get a good picture. But then that's not true. To me, that's not true. To talk on the photography awards, yeah, in Kenya, like, we've not really been given a chance, like, as photographers, I can say. Because, no, the reason why I'm saying this is because, yeah, we have many photographers in Kenya, but some have been there for quite a long period of time. But there are some upcomers also, like some people who are coming, you know, some people who are getting better in photography. But this chance only goes to the professional photographers who have been there for a long time and who are well known, you know. Like the Kenyan Canon Photography Awards that were organized, like I saw no new photographer there, you know. Like the same people were there, just the same people whom I knew, like were professional photographers. And another photography awards are like the Lucy Foundation Photography. You have the My Africa Photography, like getting tear gas out there, you know. You nosebleed from the tear gas. Yeah, like I've been in such situations where sometimes I'm just in the middle of nowhere. You're running through the smoke, and the policemen are after you sometimes, you know. But the good thing is that you're not being shot. You're just being caned. People throwing stones, the stones just bump onto you, and you see your fellow photographers fainting, ladies fainting, you know. You see the fellow kids fainting from the tear gas. You need to give out these stories. You end up like, all the things that you go up, you face, you don't have to give up, you know. Like, I've been to different situations. I've been to the tear gas, like I've been in Kibera where riot is taking place. I've been to Kisumu where someone is being shot dead like this. I've been to Dandora, you know. I've been in Madare, you know, where you face everything that comes. You see kids being tear gassed, women running around these communities, you know. Like policemen shooting Kenyans in live bullets. And then you're just there, you're watching, you're taking shots. Don't know what's going to come around, what's going to come next. The tear gas takes a fellow photographer down, then what do you need to do? You know? You stop taking the shots and go and help him. You leave him alone and go take the shots, you know. My fellow photographer, Ondivo, was almost dying because of the tear gas. Then we had to help him first before we could do anything, before we could take any shot. We had to make sure that our fellows are on stand. You know? No one is remaining behind. The only school that I went to was African Digital Media that helped me improve my career. through the skills that I got from my different teachers, my lecturers out there. Yeah, I found African digital media just as a joke because I was browsing online on how I could get a school on, to upgrade more about my photography skills. Then I came across ADMI. Then I think this was the best school that I chose. I managed to get a scholarship of 2 years, you know, to study for 2 years in film and TV production. And I believe that through the documentaries that I've been producing, the skills that I'm going to gain here in the 2 years that are coming will be more enough to make me be on my level best. I'd like to advise my fellow people, like my fellow upcoming photographers, like, it's not an easy journey. Go down on your knees, pray to your picture, you know? You close one of your eyes, pray. That's a prayer that you normally give. For me, that's what I can say. Because there comes a time when you have to pray for a camera, you know? Go down on your one knee, close one of your eyes, hands on the shutter, you know? And make sure you get the best that you want, you know? Ask questions on things that you don't know. Advice, you know? Like, I'm happy when my fellow photographers are asking me, like, Don, okay, I took this image and I was wondering about the light that it should be on. I was wondering about the exposure. I was wondering about the rules of thirds. Have I applied any rule here, you know? And I feel happy, you know, sharing the same knowledge that I have. If it's, like, above me, then I'll try to involve many people in it who know about photography. Yeah. For more information about me, you can get me on Don Wilson Magazine. That's my Facebook page. And my WordPress account is, my WordPress page is like Don Wilson Kibera. You can find me on Don Wilson Kibera. And YouTube, I'm just still called Picture Don. Dial Picture Don and you'll see my video products. And Instagram, Picture Don, Twitter, @DonWilsonOdia1. Yeah.